Hello everyone and welcome to the New Hits, where I cover brand new top 40 entries, judging their quality and how much longevity I think they'll have. This week we had a bunch of new debuts, the latest singles from artists both beginning and approaching the climax of their album cycles, plus a couple of rising hits. Let's get to the first of those. What you know about rolling down in the TikTok hit Inbound. Masked Wolf is a rapper from Australia, and this is a 2019 cut of his gaining momentum, and probably the first major hit from someone I'd consider adjacent to YouTube rap. Not too educated in that field, so feel free to correct me on that, but I noticed a number of hallmarks of that sound here, including prioritizing fast-paced flows, and an unashamed connection to religion. Masked Wolf references his belief in the Christian God here. That's just offhand lines, as the main focus of the song is his struggles with depression and anxiety, and many metaphors are brought to the table to explain his mental state at the time, and how he now hopes he's gotten out of that rut. I think he loses focus on a couple occasions, but doesn't come off as a poor writer. He brings some impressive flows to the mix and switches them adeptly, and the production absolutely kills, but all the while, I don't get the sense that I'm missing much beyond this introduction. Masked Wolf's bells and whistles I'm sure I can find elsewhere from a more gripping act. With Astronaut in the ocean, though, he's definitely struck gold, and I'm more than pleased to have him in the scene right now. This gets an 8 out of 10, great. The momentum is strong here, I can see this rocketing farther up the charts, but I will question whether it can stay up there once it reaches those heights. Next up, a superstar brings a newcomer into the limelight. While there's no official announcement of a new Lil Baby project coming, I can only assume that it will be happening, with a brand new single showing up as On Me reaches the apex of its run. Louisville rapper ESTG, who might be recognizable from Jack Harlow's recent album, is brought along for the ride of this one. Lil Baby has been one of the most consistently rising artists quality-wise, in my view, since his debut, and this serves as no exception. He employs some of his best-ever flows here, although that's not too much in the way of variety in that regard. Variety, though, can be found in ESTG, who, considering the track record of unknown features, I wasn't expecting to impress, but his lower voice complements Lil Baby, and I found myself getting wrapped up in his off-kilter flows. The synth line, which somewhat reminded me of the Bigger Pictures piano line, makes a nice change of pace from those pianos, which have become all too common in trap as of late. This one is just a straight banger, and a well-executed one at that, feeling an 8 out of 10 great for this. I think this could become a big streaming hit, but I don't see a lot of longevity in its future. Now, a country song about country songs. The return of Thomas Rhett, this time working off of a number of references to country classics, both new and old, an idea I can't say I'm a fan of. To be fair, the country list format certainly works better for this idea than it did for the similar 2002 by Anne Marie, if anyone remembers that track. And Rhett doesn't just spout buzz phrases like she did, he incorporates these shoutouts in a sort of storytelling way throughout the verses. With as flawed a concept as this song had, I think those parts of it handle it pretty much to the best way it could have been. The hook, though, is where the writing begins to unravel, as the entire song is revealed to be Rhett's attempting to come onto a girl with the title question. Certainly not creepy, but weird all the same. My appreciation for what this song does right is quashed by that point, if not by Rhett's middling performance and his usual brand of artificial production. So yeah, while there are good moments here, there's not enough for me to latch onto to justify seeking those out. This gets a 5 out of 10, okay. This is rocketing to number one on country radio, and I don't want to jinx myself again, but I do feel like this one will last a little longer than the previous recent contenders, which have all flopped as soon as they touch the top 40. We'll have to see. And now, the channel's biggest arc continues. I need you to hold on, heaven. Back to Justin. The album dropped today as of when I'm writing this, and I'm sure I'll be talking about a chunk of it in a couple weeks' time, but for now, his latest single. I mentioned in my commentary on Anyone that I wished Bieber would work with Andrew Watt more often, as with It and Monster, the two have tended to bring out the best in each other. Well, my wish has come true, going by the Watt credit on this track, and the gradual quality increase of Justice singles continues. A big change from the swelling grandeur of Anyone, this track is rooted in the groovy bass line of the hook, but Justin's passion hasn't gone anywhere as he belts out the lyrics, still admittedly generic in their pleas for the subject to hold on to Bieber in their times of need, but really, for a pop song of this nature, production of this standard is pretty much all you need to get the thumbs up from me, if not my admiration. Quality pop tune, as Bieber has been usually pushing out lately. This gets a 7 out of 10, good. From what I'm seeing, with there apparently being a further two new songs off the album getting a streaming playlist push, I can't say I'm super confident about this track's chances. Hold On will probably get a stellar radio run, but if new singles come too fast, that could get cut short. Next, 2021's first grand return. A ton of artists are being waited on to release new material in 2021. Adele, Rihanna, Kendrick, Frank Ocean, list goes on. But Bruno Mars is the first out the gate with this collaborative project with Anderson .Paak, a name that's been clawing its way into the mainstream for a good few years now and might have just found the breakthrough. Song treads much the life of luxury stylings Mars employed on his previous project, but the rowdy nature of those singles is traded for a smooth, soulful vibe. Bruno Mars switches from belting to crooning to back again perfectly as he sings about a budding relationship on the hook, while Paak holds the verses for some sultry downtime. The production here is simply gorgeous. It manages to evoke that soul sound the song is going for without feeling like pastiche, as in much of Bruno's other work. This is just one of those songs that's self-evident in its quality. You don't need anything explained to you, you just know on first listen that something special is happening. Absolutely amazing. Easy 9 out of 10. Excellent. It seems that Bruno Mars' star power has failed to diminish in his absence as the song is speeding up the radio and staying steady elsewhere, and it's looking like this is, at the moment, challenging Bieber's latest single for number one. Longevity is in the cards, but I'll hold my judgment until I see what radio-listening public thinks of this. And finally, let's quickly run through Drake's EP in reverse order. Yeah. Drake once again collabs with Rick Ross, and while Ross opens the cut, the spotlight is firmly on Drake for much of the song's runtime. And while the song certainly had potential to be great, Drake and Rick Ross both give quality performances and the beat and sample are amazing, the song quickly finds itself tanked by its length. It clocks in at 6.5 minutes, and I can't say either artist makes full use of the time they're given. The content here isn't too interesting. In terms of these two linking up for smashes, I'll stick with Money in the Grave. This gets a 5 out of 10 okay. Here, Drake brings in an artist he originally brought to the limelight for their biggest ever peak. Make no mistake, Drake is very greatly outshined on his own song here. I'd honestly go so far as to say that not only is this Lil Baby's chart peak, this might be the best verse he's ever dropped. This is assisted by the production, though. It's dark, dripping beat that amplifies all the good in this song, and there is quite a bit of it, a lot. The hook is probably the song's weak point, and even then, the strong atmosphere surrounding it prevents me from knocking it. In comparison to the previous song, being a succinct 3 minutes is only the cherry on top. Definitely my favorite Drake cut since Nice for What. This gets a 9 out of 10. Excellent. For the opener and big single, Drake hops on a hard-hitting, oscillating beat for his traditional braggadocious style done in above-average fashion. The star of the show here is, in contrast to Wants and Needs, Drake's sarcastic hook, taking shots at people trying to peek into his private life. A number of other good lines slip their way in, the most obvious being the takedown of artists making use of bundles. True, this is pretty much Drake coasting, but certain aspects such as the beat come together to end up making more than that. This gets a 7 out of 10, good. For these three songs, Lemon Pepper Freestyle absolutely will not last, but What's Next is a surefire hit, if not one likely to have too much longevity, and if it gets pushed later, I could say the same for Wants and Needs. So, that's our week. Pretty impressive slate, a number of songs I love and only a couple I pass on. Next week, we've got a quiet one in the run-up to Justin Bieber's album bomb with no big releases, but maybe we could see some rising hits sneaking their way in. Till next time, see you on the next episode of The New Hits.